नॉकिंग इन स्पार्क इग्निशन इंजन कैन बी रिड्यूस्ड बाय, फोर ऑप्शंस आर गिवन. वन इज रिटार्डिंग द स्पार्क, ऑप्शन टू इज सुपर चार्जिंग, ऑप्शन थ्री इंक्रीजिंग द इंजन स्पीड, स्टेटमेंट फोर यूजिंग अ फ्यूल ऑफ लॉन्ग स्ट्रेट चेन स्ट्रक्चर. नाउ सेलेक्ट द करेक्ट आंसर यूजिंग द कोड गिवन बिलो. फोर ऑप्शन आर गिवन, वन एंड फोर, वन एंड थ्री, टू एंड थ्री एंड टू एंड फोर. नाउ टू स्टार्ट सच क्वेश्चन वी नीड टू अटैक ऑन ईच एंड एवरी स्टेटमेंट वेरी केयरफुली. दिस आर सम माइलस्टोन क्वेश्चंस ऑफ दिस इंजीनियरिंग सर्विस एग्जामिनेशन. दिस आर वेरी स्पेसिफिक क्वेश्चंस. यू विल फाइंड सच क्वेश्चंस इन प्लेंटी ऑफ नंबर्स. सो यू नीड टू अटेम्प्ट दिस क्वेश्चंस वेरी केयरफुली. स्टेटमेंट वन, रिटार्डिंग द स्पार्क. नाउ फर्स्ट द क्वेश्चन इज ऑल अबाउट नॉकिंग, नॉकिंग और डिटोनेशन. इन एनी स्पार्क इग्निशन इंजन द रीजन बिहाइंड नॉकिंग इज इफ it is your cylinder and it is your piston. So first we'll get to know how this knocking happens. So if there is a flame front which is going from here to the second end, when spark happens and a flame front is going towards the other end, at the same time due to very high pressure in the cylinder or very high temperature in the cylinder, some particles ignite themselves, like self-ignition happens for some particles. Due to this, another flame front is passing in the cylinder. When these two flame fronts strikes, or when these two flame fronts passes through each other, there is a pressure wave generated, very high pressure wave, and this is known as knocking. Now will attack all these four statements on this particular principle to know whether this principle can be avoided or not, whether this thing can be avoided by this particular statement or not. If we retard the spark, if we will retard the spark, the peak pressure will reduce. If pressure reduces, there are less chances that these particle will self ignite. If pressure is less, that means temperature is less. If temperature is less, that means the particle which ignited itself won't be able to do that. So statement one might look correct. So statement one is correct from these particular phenomena. Now statement two, what is supercharging? Supercharging is a method to increase density. In supercharging, we increase the density of the intake air. Now, if we increase the density of intake air, the intake temperature also gets increases. Now, temperature increases, pressure gets increases. That means there is more chance. It is properly a liability for the cylinder to produce knocking. So the statement two is incorrect. Statement two is incorrect. Statement one is correct. Now statement number three, increasing the engine speed. If we increase the engine speed, the most important feature we obtain from that is turbulence. Now if turbulence is increased, that means velocity of the flame front inside the cylinder will increase. Now if this velocity or randomness is increased, that means this flame will reach to the other end more fast or quickly than the previous case. That means it can help in reducing, it can help in reducing the knocking phenomenon. And option number four, using a fuel of long straight chain structure. This might be correct, but it is not always the case. So we won't go for statement number four. स्टेटमेंट नंबर फोर कैन बी करेक्ट और कैन नॉट बी करेक्ट, बट स्टेटमेंट नंबर टू इज इनकरेक्ट, स्टेटमेंट वन एंड थ्री आर करेक्ट. सो आर ऑप्शन कैन बी स्टेटमेंट वन थ्री एंड फोर इफ एन ऑप्शन वॉज गिवन ए वन एंड टू, बी वन एंड थ्री, सी वन थ्री एंड फोर, देन वी वुड हैव टिक्ड वन थ्री एंड फोर. बट इन आवर ऑप्शंस वी हैव चॉइसेस एंड द मोस्ट अप्रोप्रिएट चॉइस इज ऑप्शन बी, दैट इज वन एंड थ्री, बिकॉज ऑप्शन नंबर फोर इज नॉट ऑलवेज करेक्ट. सो वी कैन गो फॉर ऑप्शन नंबर बी, दैट इज स्टेटमेंट वन एंड थ्री करेक्ट. अ फोर सिलेंडर डीजल इंजन रनिंग एट 1200 आरपीएम डेवलप्ड 18.6 किलोवाट. नाउ द एवरेज टॉर्क व्हेन वन सिलेंडर वॉज कट ऑफ इज 105 न्यूटन मीटर. इफ द कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू ऑफ द फ्यूल वॉज 42000 किलो जूल पर केजी एंड द इंजन यूज 0.34 केजी ऑफ डीजल पर किलोवाट आर, द इंडिकेटेड थर्मल एफिशिएंसी वॉज नियरली. इट इज वन ऑफ द ब्यूटिफुल प्रॉब्लम. इट इज फ्रॉम टॉपिक आईसी इंजन. इट इज क्वाइट कैलकुलेटिव वन. The options you can see are very close to each other. If in engineering service examination you find such questions in which so much calculation is involved, you do not have any calculator, access to any calculator, and all the options are very close to each other, it is advisable to leave such questions and move forward. It is advisable, but still we'll see how this question is solved. The given data is omega or n, your speed of engine is 1200 rpm. Okay, the power developed, it is brake power. So brake power is 18.6 kilowatt. The average torque when one cylinder was cut off, so it is brake power with four cylinders. So we can write it as brake power with four cylinders, and brake power with three cylinders can be calculated by the given data. How? We know power is torque into omega, so that can be calculated because one cylinder is cut off, that means three cylinders are working, and the net power can be calculated by this formula. The torque is given 105 and omega can be calculated from this 1200 into 2 pi by 60. Why 2 pi by 60? It is in RPM and we need omega in radian per second. So the brake power from this three cylinders will be somewhat equal to 13.188 kilowatt. You can calculate this and you will find brake power with three cylinders is this. Now, how to calculate indicated thermal efficiency? To calculate indicated thermal efficiency, you must be knowing something apart than brake power, because brake power can get you brake thermal efficiency. But for indicated thermal efficiency, we know the formula indicated is indicated power upon into calorific value. It is nothing but heat supplied. And it is indicated power. Indicated power is the diagram power, the indicator diagram power. Now brake power is with us. Now how to calculate it? How to calculate indicative power? To calculate this, there is one method. That method can be solved over here. We can write indicated power as brake power plus some loss in friction power. Actually, indicated power is what was developed inside engine, and brake power is the power which was supplied to any system, and in between these two there are some losses due to friction. So some energy is lost in form of friction. So there was an experiment called Moore's experiment. In that ही कैलकुलेटेड अ मैथड, ही फॉर्म्ड अ मैथड टू कैलकुलेट दिस इंडिकेटेड पावर. टू फाइंड दिस इंडिकेटेड पावर द सेम डेटा इज गिवन, लाइक वन सिलेंडर शुड बी कट ऑफ. सो इनिशियली विथ फोर सिलेंडर्स इंडिकेटेड पावर वॉज 4 इंटू इंडिकेटेड पावर, ब्रेक पावर वॉज ब्रेक पावर ऑफ 4 सिलेंडर्स, एंड फ्रिक्शन पावर विल बी सेम बिकॉज आरपीएम इज सेम. आरपीएम इज सेम, दैट मीन्स फ्रिक्शन पावर विल बी सेम. नाउ विथ वन सिलेंडर कट ऑफ ओनली 3 सिलेंडर्स विल बी प्रोड्यूसिंग पावर. सो 3 इंटू इंडिकेटेड पावर शुड बी इक्वल टू ब्रेक पावर प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय 3 सिलेंडर्स प्लस फ्रिक्शन पावर. सिंस देयर इज नो चेंज इन आरपीएम, देयर वॉन्ट बी एनी चेंज इन फ्रिक्शन पावर, बिकॉज वंस द आरपीएम इज फिक्स्ड, योर फ्रिक्शन टू ओवरकम दैट पर्टिकुलर आरपीएम इज फिक्स्ड. नाउ वी कैन कैलकुलेट, वी कैन सब्ट्रैक्ट इक्वेशन नंबर 2 फ्रॉम इक्वेशन नंबर 1. फ्रॉम हियर दिस फ्रिक्शन पावर विल गेट कैंसल्ड, दिस वॉज अननोन टर्म, सो वी हैव कैंसल्ड दिस टर्म. 4ip minus 3ip will be equal to ip is equal to brake power with 4 cylinders minus brake power with 3 cylinders working. So this particular term is already known, 18.6 it is given in question, and brake power with 3 cylinders working 13.188. This is what we have calculated from here. So from here we can calculate indicated power as 5.412 kilowatt. It is indicated power of one cylinder. Now, four cylinders are working in your engine. So, indicated power of four cylinders will be equal to 4 times this term. So, 4 into 5.412, that will be equal to 21.64 kilowatt. Now, you have got indicated power of the engine. For efficiency, you were waiting for this indicated power as well as heat supply. Now, indicated power is with you. Now, how to calculate this heat supply? For heat supplied to the engine, you are given calorific value of your diesel or fuel. And this mass flow rate of fuel is not given. So, calorific value is already with you. Mass flow rate you need to calculate. To calculate this mass flow rate, there must be some hint given in the question. The hint is, engine used 0.34 kg of diesel per kilowatt hour. It is known as, this specific term is known as BSFC, brake specific fuel consumption. So, it is given as 0.34, and this BSFC is nothing but mass of fuel, mass flow rate of fuel upon brake power. So from here we can calculate mass flow rate of the fuel is 0.34 multiply by brake power. What is brake power? 18.6. And since in this particular question it is given kilowatt hour, so we need to calculate, we need to divide this term by 3600 to bring it back in kg per second, because we want SI units with us. So from here mass flow rate will be equal to 1.75 into 10 power minus 3 kg per second. Now can we go for efficiency directly? Yes, from here we can write our efficiency term, efficiency, indicative efficiency, that is equal to indicated power, that is 21.64 kilowatt. So same unit should be in denominator, 1.75 into 10 power minus 3 multiply by, what is calorific value? Calorific value is 42,000. And what is unit? It is kg per second, it is kilojoule per kg. So it will be kilojoule per second. So again it is kilowatt only. So this is how we wanted our equation to be, kilowatt kilowatt. So the final efficiency term will be unitless. From this particular equation, our answer will come to be 0.294, or we can write it as 29.4%. We have option A, so final answer what we can quote is A, that is 29%. It is the nearest value from 29.4. Such questions cannot be solved without calculator in engineering service examination. These are tricky questions. This differentiates between the students who can leave the question and move ahead. So if such questions come in your examination, you must leave such questions. Leave it for last. Give it a try when everything else is done. So final answer will be A, 29%. The question statement is, in a Morse test on a two-cylinder, two-stroke SI engine, the brake power is 9 kilowatt and the BHP, brake horsepower, of individual cylinders with spark cutoff are 4.25 kilowatt and 3.75 kilowatt respectively. The mechanical efficiency of the engine is. It is again a question on Morse test. It is quite easy. We can attempt such questions. For any engine, we can write brake power as indicated power minus friction power. This is how any engine works. It is indicated power developed inside the engine cylinder. It is friction power to overcome all the friction losses, and it is brake power, final output of the engine. In our question, we want to calculate, or we are asked to calculate, mechanical efficiency. That is nothing but brake power upon indicated power. Since we are given brake power with two cylinder is already given, that is 9 kilowatt. We want to calculate brake power, indicated power of two cylinders. Now to calculate this, we'll use Morse test method. And how this method is used? Brake power with two cylinder will be equal to 2 IP minus friction power. So, and brake power with one cylinder will be equal to indicated power minus friction power. So, brake power with one cylinder, we do not know this value exactly, but an experiment data is given that when spark is cut off in individual cylinders, the brake power are 4.25 and 3.75. So we can calculate this term by averaging both the values, 4.25 and 3.75 divided by 2, that is 4 kilowatt. Now we can use these two formula and putting the value, brake power for two cylinder is 9 is equal to 2 times IP minus friction power. Similarly, brake power with one cylinder is 4 and IP, it is unknown to us, minus friction power. From these two equations, it will get cancelled. It will be 5 is equal to indicated power. It is indicated power of one cylinder. So for two cylinders, indicated power will be equal to 5 into 2, that is 10 kilowatt. Now efficiency, mechanical, is brake power upon indicated power. Brake power, it is 9, indicated power for the engine is 10. Efficiency will be 0.9 or 90%. So final answer is A, 90%. Statement 1, air blast injection in diesel engine could reduce engine efficiency. Statement 2, air blast injection in diesel engine is not instantaneous but happens when the piston moves outward with injection valve remaining open for whatever reason. Now these two statements are given and we need to choose correct explanation or correct answer. Now statement 1 is, एयर ब्लास्ट इंजन इन डीजल, एयर ब्लास्ट इंजेक्शन सिस्टम इन डीजल इंजन कुड रिड्यूस इंजन एफिशिएंसी. नाउ इन डीजल इंजन सेवरल इंजेक्शन सिस्टम्स आर यूज्ड. एयर ब्लास्ट इंजेक्शन सिस्टम वाज वेरी ओल्ड सिस्टम विच वाज यूज्ड एंड राइट नाउ इन प्रेजेंट सिनेरियो सच सिस्टम इज ऑब्सोलीट. सो सच एयर ब्लास्ट इंजेक्शन सिस्टम्स आर नॉट यूज्ड राइट नाउ इन आवर डीजल इंजन्स. इन वेरी ओल्ड इंजन्स इट मे बी देयर बट राइट नाउ दिस सिस्टम इज नॉट यूज्ड. नाउ एयर ब्लास्ट इंजेक्शन इन डीजल इंजन कुड रिड्यूस इंजन एफिशिएंसी. दैट इज वेरी करेक्ट. दैट वाज वन ऑफ द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रीजन व्हाई सच सिस्टम गॉट ऑब्सोलीट. व्हाई दिस थिंग हैपन व्हेन एयर ब्लास्ट इंजेक्शन सिस्टम इज यूज्ड इन एनी डीजल इंजन. इट हैज एन एयर कंप्रेसर. इट हैज एन एयर कंप्रेसर. नाउ दिस एयर कंप्रेसर हैज इट्स ओन वेट विच मेक्स दिस इंजेक्शन सिस्टम क्वाइट हैवी. नाउ विथ दिस एयर कंप्रेसर हाईली कंप्रेस्ड एयर इज इंजेक्टेड इन द सिस्टम. नाउ ड्यू टू दिस वेरी हाई प्रेशर द वर्क आउटपुट समटाइम्स रिड्यूसेस. नेटवर्क आउटपुट. वाई? बिकॉज फर्स्ट एनर्जी इज यूटिलाइज्ड फॉर एयर कंप्रेशन ऑल्सो for that particular compressor which compresses the air, and second it is quite heavy, so final our work output reduces, and hence if work output is reduced for a given input, efficiency will decrease. So statement one is correct, that air blast injection system is having low efficiency. Now statement two, air blast injection in diesel engine is not instantaneous but happens when piston moves outward with the injection valve remaining open for whatever reason. This statement is incorrect, because in air blast injection system, the name suggests air blast. That means in one very high pressure, with very high pressure around 60 to 70 bar pressure, this highly compressed air goes inside the compressed cylinder. Now the process is not instantaneous. It is incorrect. So statement 2 will be incorrect. So our answer will be statement 1 is correct, statement 2 is not correct. So final answer we can write as C, where statement 1 is true but statement 2 is false.